Good afternoon, Boomi fans, and welcome back to Dallas, Texas. We're here on the back end of our 2 days of coverage at Boomi World 2025. My name is Savannah Peterson, bringing you all the fun and insights with Paul this week. Paul, what a great show.
It's been an outstanding show.
I think this was a little more in your wheelhouse than you were expecting.
It really was, yeah, absolutely. I was really excited. Boomi has really grown, and you know, a lot of
cool
things happening. And of course, AI.
Yeah, I know, what? We haven't talked about that at all. Speaking of the conversation we're going to have next, Luke, welcome to the show. Thank you for being here.
It's a pleasure to be here, Savannah.
Very excited about this. We are going to be, I love that we were just chatting before we went live. Your job title didn't exist a couple years ago.
That's right.
Head of Enterprise AI. Pretty cool. Been with Boomi for a year and a half. Talk to us a little bit about how you all drink your own champagne internally when it comes to these tools.
We love the champagne here. So Boomi platform is
who doesn't?
Yeah. It's tremendous, right? Yeah. We've got all these resources across API management, data management, integration, and now Agentstudio. And that really helps me out a lot because my job is infuse this into every customer interaction that we have, every business process. And so I need the tools to really scale, you know, for that mandate.
Yeah.
You know what's really cool though, you just mentioned a number of tools and all that, but it's a one platform approach, which is really, really powerful, right? It's that unified view, that focus that you're looking at. I think that you know, your heritage really kind of amplifies how you're moving forward, right? So if you look at the integration and all how all the systems kind of played together, when we look at the AI strategy and where it's going, blending the past with the future, what are your thoughts there?
I mean, we're learning so much, so you really have to have a learner's mindset right now. We're trying a lot of things. Having a great foundation is really critical.
Sure.
Right? So I love the comments that have been made around change at the speed of trust.
Yeah, right? It's one of my favorite lines of the week.
Being able to build on a trusted foundation. And one of the things that I didn't expect coming into this job was just how much I was going to learn and participate in security.
Yeah. Right?
So you really need to have that discipline and your partners that you work with. You know, you need to earn the next AI use case and you prove yourself on the battlefield each and every day.
Yep, well stated. Nice soundbite there, Luke, love that. Wait, so talk to me a little bit more about, so how, I'm curious, I love that you brought up that experimentation and the curiosity mindset. I've been talking about the curiosity quotient a lot on the show lately, because that's what's driving a lot of this innovation.
Right.
Talk to me about the design process. How long are you testing things internally and iterating on them before you're serving them out to your customers?
Well, we're moving really fast. So, you know, if I rewind just a year and a half ago, we had all these LLMs coming out. We didn't know which ones we should be working with.
Yeah.
We said, hey, we've got the Boomi platform, and we could take an API-first approach, connect this thing to not just one, but multiple, and give safe and secure AI to all of our teammates. And that's how we built ChatB. That's how it was born. We wanted an interface for all of our teammates to use where they weren't asking us, hey, can I put sensitive data into this tool? Is that going to be okay?
Yeah.
And so we all started learning together, and we could measure progress.
That's pretty awesome. Yeah. So what are some of the use cases for ChatB? What do people do with it?
So we really started off with sales and marketing, right? People don't want to learn how to become a prompt engineer, but as we all know, the more data and more context that you put into these large language models, the better outputs that you're going to get. So we did the work with the sales teams to kind of figure out, you know, what are your use cases? Do you want, you know, a sales coach? Do you need to craft a pitch that uses all of the, you know, ICP messaging and understands our product positioning and common, you know, voice and tone of how we pull together all of our marketing? So putting that in the hands of our sellers has really turbocharged things for our team.
Yeah, I can imagine.
And, well, I was going to say on ChatB and Boomi Connect for that matter, right? I think that there's the interesting piece about that is, excuse me, the interesting piece about that is the individuals that you're working with, they're working with bespoke tools, right? They're using their own tools. And now this is kind of harmonizing those tools and allowing for different technology to kind of work together without having to have like silos and stovepipes. Is that what your vision is or where it's kind of going?
Absolutely. I mean, we've been in the age of API sprawl and now we're getting into agent sprawl and AI tool sprawl. So everybody wants to try these new things. but they're like, what's safe, right? And how can I work it into my workflow? So for us, controlling the user experience and having a common intranet where everyone can come, they can discover agents, they can get recommendations from us on what they should be using based on their job, role, and function, right? We can make it more seamless for their experience. So that's what we're really trying to do, have this, you know, super intelligent system that can make us all superhuman.
I mean, we're here for that, right?
Yeah.
I'm ready to be a superhero. Let's get the capes out.
Superhuman, superhero, that's amazing. Yeah, where do I sign up?
Yeah, I know. Well, but speaking about, coming back to your earlier point about security and about governance, I think that's really imperative. Everyone's excited, we do want everyone prototyping and doing things, but you're going to let agents loose on a lot of highly sensitive data. There's a lot of risk there.
It's not easy. Hard work.
I was just going to ask, so how do you do that?
Yeah. Well, that's why I'm so excited about Agentstudio, because we've been doing practical AI the hard way, right? Mm. Working through every API, making sure that all these things are scoped so it's least privilege, right? And then you've got to expose these tools to different systems. And so just cataloging all of that stuff, having the capabilities to make all these things talk to each other, that's really difficult.
Yeah.
So with this new platform that we have, we're able to put more tools in the hands of our developers, right? Mm-hmm. They can move faster and that increases our velocity, ability to deploy these things.
Safely. Yeah, safely, and that's important, right? Yeah. Because when we look at the growth factor of these applications, the tech stack is not getting easier, right? And the way we were traditionally developing applications was that hard-coded approach, right? It's like, it's very much the A to B, and you have to put the, you know, write the glue to make it all stick,
right?
And that required a lot of testing, a lot of like time and such. What I see in our research is we see organizations want to release code on an hourly basis. Actually, 24% of respondents in a recent survey said they want to do it on an hourly basis, yet only 8% were able to do so. And with the with the cadence of driving that rapid release of code, you can't hard code everything.
No.
You just can't do it.
Yeah.
So this dynamic approach on the platform is really, I find it very intriguing.
Right.
Yeah, no, I think it is really intriguing. I'm curious, what's the attitude like internally as you roll out these new tools for everybody? Is everyone excited?
We're trying to be AI first, right?
Yeah.
So we have a strong mandate from the top, which is phenomenal, right? Everything that we do is business driven in the AI world, which has really contributed to our success with ChatB and Boomi Connect, because the business is driving the imperatives. Now, we're all going on an AI adoption journey, right? Whether we like it or not, the era of AI is here. We're all experiencing this change at a different pace, right? So we do have, you know, different dynamics across our workforce.
Yeah.
Where, you know, some people are seeing lots of value, leaning in, experimenting, and we have other areas where, you know, we're wait and see. And we've also seen over time that there's different use cases, and some use cases, hallucination's a feature, right?
Yeah.
In sales and marketing, you want that great email and you're willing to, you know, take some liberties and pulling together great content.
Yeah.
In the finance organization, the back office, you can't have hallucination in your, you know, entries to your general ledger.
Right, right. Last place you want
last
that to happen.
Place,
yeah,
right.
Yeah.
So we're conservative in the right places, and it's just about bringing everybody along on this adoption journey.
And how do, which makes a lot of sense. I was curious, you know, you can't, we might be in a new era, but that doesn't mean you change the disposition of certain roles and people who are doing stuff and making sure, being a little skeptical at first of something new, just because that's the nature of the beast. How do you, I'm thinking of like the brainstorming scene where you're all thinking about what to build next. How do you manage prioritization of what you're developing for your squad internally?
That's another area where just having strong leadership coalition, right?
Yeah.
Makes things possible.
Yeah.
So we have an investment council, we look at how much overall we want to invest in AI, right? And then we work through, you know, what are the use cases and the areas. So every function has AI on their objectives and key results for the year.
Yeah.
The question is, which use cases are going to move the needle on those, and then how do we prioritize, and how much can we execute on? And having Boomi with Agentstudio now, we just got leveled up in terms of being able to do more agents faster. We don't have to worry about, you know, handcrafting all the things around the agents.
Yeah.
All that reporting, the audit trails, the guardrails, like starting to get that stuff out of the box just helps us go really fast.
So I think that there's something very interesting in what you just talked about. The audience watching is thinking about where they do their next move, their next investment. With the rapid changes in AI, it's, you know, you don't know which, you know, horse to attach a cart to, right? And there's all these different things happening. And that was one of the things I like about, you don't like that analogy?
No, you're great. I'm smiling. I'm supporting you.
Okay. But one of the things I like about Boomi is the ability to be dynamic, and you can be fluid and you're changing. So if you do actually align to a specific tech stack, and that tech stack shifts, you have the ability to be dynamic and fluid. I think, you know, one of the things the audience would want to hear is, when you think about your strategic investments in AI, what's some advice you would give to the audience to say, if they're looking at it from their perspective, from their organizations, what would you guide them to say?
Right now, having flexibility is so important, right? We're in uncertain times, right? The horse race is going to continue to evolve.
Absolutely.
Being able to try different, you know, tools in the tech stack, different components, you know. As a builder, I want lots of different Legos that I can try to pull into my you know, toolkit here and use. And so just keeping that as an imperative, right? We'll see where the market, you know, lands on all of this. But that flexibility, I may be in multiple clouds. I may have things on-prem, right? We're seeing edge AI and edge computing, you know, come into the fold.
50% of data at the edge.
At the edge. We saw a robot, right? At Boomi World. So, you know, we need to be able to control those things, and workloads are going to shift around. So maintaining that flexibility is really key. And so it's a API first world now, and you need to really go with that.
Yeah, absolutely. What about you personally? What do you hope that AI does for you, weekend Luke?
Weekends, Luke. Well, it already helped my wife and I plan our 20th anniversary trip, so.
Very good. Yeah. Wait, so how? Tell me.
Well, we're going to Iceland, and my wife fired up ChatGPT. You know, she's like, fine, I'll use ChatGPT, because, you know, I wasn't being a helpful planner for her. And she laid out, you know, ask it questions, worked through an itinerary, came up with all the things that she wanted to do, and just shortened that whole trip planning cycle. So
that's awesome.
Yeah, so that's one, and you know, I'm trying to bring her along. She's on the, you know, the lagging side of AI adoption.
Yeah.
But, you know, you have to have balance in the family, right?
Absolutely. Well, and I mean, to be fair, we're still very in the early days of a lot of things right now. Just because we're these zealous early adopters who are a part of this ecosystem, you know, nerds are having a moment right now, which is great.
Sure are.
But you know, I think that's really great, though. I mean, what a great, I love the travel agent notion of that, and such a fun way to go back and forth and find me a restaurant near the great place that
that's
you're going
to
go hang
out. That's
right.
And then if you have an agent, go book it for me, right?
Yeah. Yeah, we've been talking about how lovely it'll be when the agents take care of everything. You know, I was joking that next year, well, maybe not even joking, it's probably real, Boomi World next year, you guys will probably have the agents do everything in terms of our booking and everything that happens.
The Boomi World agent.
Yeah, exactly. I'll just get my, you know, like a little agent will send us an email with our with our list of interviews and everything that's going
on. I want to meet with these kind of customers and these partners and talk about these products. Please match me.
Yeah, I mean, it's a pretty great use case when you really think about it. I think there's a lot of fun there. All right, one final question for you, Luke. When we are hanging out here at Boomi World 2026, in Chicago, I believe, what do you hope to be able to say then that you can't yet say today?
Wow, that's a good one. Well, I think handling, first of all, I want zero security incidents, right? So that's an OKR for me.
Yeah.
I love where all this technology is going, but I stay up at night, you know, with all of the risks and concerns, because we have just all of these emerging, you know, threat vectors.
Yeah.
And my partnership with my CISO, my Chief Information Security Officer, is phenomenal. And I want to double down on that, because I'm constantly learning and investing so much in security. So my hope is, with broader rollout of Agentstudio and more agents coming to fruition, we can have a A+ security scorecard. And you know, our customers are trusting us, and we're building on that.
Love that. Well, you're A+ for us today, Luke. Thank you so much for taking the time.
Thank you so much for having me.
Appreciate it. And you too, Paul. Always
thank
a
you,
blast.
Thank you.
I hope you're having as much fun as we're having here in Dallas, Texas at Boomi World 2025. My name is Savannah Peterson. You're watching theCUBE, the leading source for enterprise tech news.